Yo, 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 what is going on? I am so excited to bring you this. And who am I? I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. You better believe it. What do? I teach accounting, basic blocks, basics, building blocks, building blocks, building blocks, building blocks. I also educate, motivate, and inspire. I do it all on this channel. Just little old me, do it all by myself. You know what it is. And I happen to have the best playlist in the entire world. It happens to be an accounting playlist, but it's the best one in the whole world. What's going on with my head? I'm feeling a little jacked up. I'm feeling good today. I'm feeling good. You know? Ugh. That's what you get, you know? You get CPA strength when he's feeling good. Because you don't need to know about the CPA strength that's not feeling good. Just know that I don't always feel good. But I'm feeling good today. I'm feeling good. And I'm super excited to bring you this episode. This is number 73 of the classic series, Accounting for Beginners, baby. That's my classic series. This is number 73. Now, it's going to be a loan from Shareholder, but it's going to be a subset. We're going to run this out to 100, okay? This is road to 100. We're going to run these out to 100. We're going to do a business. We're going to start a business from scratch. Okay, we're going to do monthly journal entries. Our first journal entry is going to be 1/1/15. Now, you're like, I don't know what's going on here. Just stick with me. Just stick with me. I think you're going to love it. I think you're going to learn the most that you could possibly learn in the next, let's see, 27, the next 5 weeks. You know, you might be, you know, you're starting a new class right now in school or whatever. This is going to be the best way, my opinion, to learn the basics of accounting. And you know, I have 70 something videos before this, so you can see, you know, like the DCA learn stuff. This is the mapping system. This is really why people listen to me mostly, I think. I mean, I do have a bubbly personality, I know, but it's a DCA learn. It's a debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. Now just think, someone who the whole world threw away at age 30 came up with this at age 37, and now the whole world knows him over. So just always, I'm always trying to progress and I'm always trying to go. Gosh, you know I can talk forever. You know I can talk forever. So let's just get into this. So we're going to start, man, we're going to start a business from scratch, okay? And here, we're gonna do a journal entry on this first board. We're gonna do the problem. We're gonna do what happened every month. We're starting at 1/1/2015. We're gonna go, you know, 27 months or whatever. So you. So anyways, the name of our business. Oh, so anyways, we're gonna do, first board is gonna be a journal entry. I have another board here with chart of accounts. We'll get that in a second. I have another board with chart of accounts and a general ledger. Then I have a third board with a balance sheet and income statement. And we're gonna do them all at once. And so we're gonna start from scratch and we're just gonna follow a business because that's how I learned the most. All right, this is bothering me. I don't know why. This is, everything bothers me. I think I have a problem. I mean, I think I have a problem, please. I know I have problems. That's part of my, it's part of why I got a little squad. Nobody's perfect, right? Well, you ain't got no problems. You're throwing widgets at a glass house. Whoop, whoop. All right, loan from, we have a company called Widget Inc. All right, Widget Inc, that's our company. Widget Inc, that's our company. Now I wanted to pick widgets because they could be whatever you want them to be. They can fit for your specific need. Don't focus so much on, like, the thing about a widget is, because if it was a piece of pizza, you'd say, well, what about this for pizza delivery? What about this? And if it was for tax returns, what about this? What about this? And I'm kind of, it has to be a moldable, the widget has to be moldable, like, for the specific video. I don't think that made much sense, but it's gonna be a widget. And so basically it can make sense for the particular video, whatever journal entry happens for the widget. And also I also want you to, you know, whenever we do a widget, whenever we sell widgets, you know, or, you know, whenever we sell widgets, or I'm not sure if it's going to be a service or a tangible good, but it could be either or, but whatever, you know, that's what we're doing. We're selling widgets. That's our thing. And a widget could be anything. I want it to be, have you ever sold anything? Can you picture your head selling something like candy or something? You know, did you ever sell candy? I guess, you know, did you ever mow lawns? Did you ever babysit? You know, I guess you had a job, so you're selling your time, so that could be a widget. I just want you to picture, you can picture what you want the widget to be. So, let me just get started here. I'm not really going to go into too much of what the DCA there is or how we get the journal entry, because I've already gone too far. I already have a loan from Shareholder journal entry somewhere in my playlist. So let's just get right into this, okay? And we're gonna just go on the road to 100. We're gonna on the road to AFB 100. Let's go. JD, that's me, the sole shareholder of Widget Inc. That's the company. And just FYI, don't tell anybody, but like we all own, just for like legal and tax return stuff, we all own Widget Inc. Everyone watching this has little stake in the company. Just want you to know that, okay? So, JD, sole shareholder of Widget Inc. Widget Inc, man, that's what we're doing. We're pumping widgets. We love pumping widgets. We think they're going to be the best company in the world. We think we're going to make all the money. Oh, it's going to be great. It's going to be so easy. We're just going to sell widgets. Everyone's going to buy a widget. Loans Widget Inc, $10,000. All right, because it's got to get off the ground. The company has nothing right now. The company has nothing. Widget Inc, it has some paperwork. Nothing, you know. What are you going to do? You're gonna loan it $10,000 in the checking account. And we're not doing cash, we're doing checking account now. So you're gonna loan it $10,000, so it has some money to get going here. It needs a lot of things before we can start selling widgets. What's the journal entry gonna be for loaning Widget Inc, loaning the company? We're gonna wear our hat, our Widget Inc hat here. Boop! Is Widget Inc, is there cash involved? Yeah, there's $10,000 cash. We're getting cash. We know that's a debit, so we're going to debit $10,000 checking account, not cash. We're going to debit $10,000 checking account. It happens to be an asset. Cash happens to be an asset. The credit for that is it's a liability because the company owes its shareholder money, so it's liable for that. If you have a liability going up, it's going to be a credit. So that's going to be our credit. $10,000 loan from shareholder liability equals $10,000 equals $10,000. It happened on 1/1/15. Now, what we're going to do, what happened there, to write checking account and loan from shareholder, those are in certain accounts. Do we have those? So what we're going to do is, I'm going to look and say I have a chart of accounts here. We wouldn't have anything in our chart of accounts because we just started, okay? So I would write in, as I'm doing this, you know, do simultaneously like in QuickBooks or in some kind of software. But, you know, you would say, okay, but anyways, you'd say, I have checking account and I have a loan from shareholder. Do I have those in my chart of accounts yet? Well, no, because I don't have anything in my chart of accounts. So I'm going to write in the chart of accounts, these two items. Okay, baby, we's back. We've got the chart of accounts. We didn't have any because this was our first one. This is our first journal entry, our first transaction of our business. So we had to write in our chart of accounts. Checking account, so we can make the journal entry somewhere. We have to have the chart of accounts, checking accounts. That's where we made our journal entry. And it happens to be under assets. And then under liabilities, we have another account that we created to record that journal entry, which is loan from shareholders. Inside of every account on the chart of accounts, there's going to be a general ledger. And the general ledger is going to be where if things happen in journal entries, it's going to go to the chart of accounts, and then a subgroup of the chart of accounts is going to be the general ledger. So inside our checking account general ledger right now, from our on 1/1/15, we have $10,000 because we got $10,000 in our checking account. Also, this is good. I was having so much fun. I was like, this is good, right? Anyways, loan from shareholders is going to be another subsection of the chart of accounts of loan from shareholder journal entry, right? And this is what happened inside our chart of accounts in the general ledger. Only one thing happened in the loan from shareholders chart of account. On 1/1/15 was $10,000. We owe JD and you $10,000. All right, what does that do? What would you do for a Klondike bar? Yo, I do a lot for a Klondike bar. Well, alrighty then, we's back. I'll tell you what happens from the balance sheet and the income statement from those items. Now, I'm gonna go fast because, as you can see, there's not gonna be too much happening because only we have one transaction. From the one transaction, we had an asset, $10,000, in the checking account, $10,000. So we had, as we know, assets equal liabilities plus equity is the balance sheet. We also had $10,000 under liabilities, loan from shareholder account. And that's all we had, the one transaction. So there's, you know, there's two parts to a transaction. So there's our two parts. Assets, $10,000 equal liabilities plus equity, $10,000, because there's no equity yet. Is the equity, there's no retained earnings, there's no net income. But that's from off the income statement. Now we haven't done anything with revenues or expenses yet, so there's nothing in our income statement. So income statement is revenue minus expenses equals the net income, and the net income flows over, from the income statement, flows over to the balance sheet. And so that's the process. It's gonna be, we're gonna do a journal entry, then we're gonna see, is it on our chart of accounts? We're gonna go from our chart of accounts to our general ledger, then we're gonna go from our general ledger to our income statement balance sheet, and then see what's going on. And we're gonna do that 26 more times, so it's gonna be a lot of fun. I hope you enjoy it. I love doing these. I'm just pumped. I feel like I'm really doing something here. I gotta remember my sleep and caffeine schedule that I just did right now. But anyways, I hope to see you on the next one. It's gonna be good. I was gonna look up there, what is this one? 73. Hope to see you in 74. It's gonna be the second one of the set. Stay positive, have fun, stay blessed, man. Just try to keep progressing, never stop. Let's go!